Dear students, last time we discussed zero field splitting and Cramer's degeneracy. Today we will continue with this very concept. As we discussed earlier, that how the zero field splitting actually complicates the EPR spectra of transition metals. Today we will continue with it. We know that in case of transition metal complexes, two effects are there. Transition metal complexes. We can have this crystal field effects. Which actually lift the degeneracy of the otherwise degenerate d orbitals in the transition metal ion. And the another thing is the spin orbit coupling. So if we have primarily the crystal field effects, that will complicate our EPR spectrum in case of this transition metal complexes, and also the spin orbit coupling. Because in case of the spin orbit coupling, we see that the energy levels which we get in case of the crystal field effects, those energy levels, what they can mix with each other. That means the ground state will mix with the excited state, so on and so forth, and they will give rise to some different, there will be rearrangement in the energies, and different energy states can exist. Okay, so these two are very crucial in terms of the EPR spectra of transition metal complexes, as they actually complicate our EPR spectrum in case of these transition metal complexes. Okay, so here we will see if this spin orbit coupling is very large, what happens when the it has been seen that when the spin orbit coupling is coupling is large, then zero field splitting is appreciable. So we can say that the zero field splitting is directly influenced by the spin orbit coupling, which occurs in case of the transition metal complexes. Okay, so what actually when there is spin orbit coupling, at that very time the spin angular momentum of that very system, that will not be simply represented by the spin only angular momentum, but that will be actually represented by the total angular spin angular momentum, which is represented by a quantum number, that is J. Okay, J will represent the total spin angular angular momentum of that system, and it is no, and not by S, which we were using in case of system where there was no spin orbit coupling. So the value, this J quantum number, that means the total spin angular momentum quantum number, this total spin angular momentum quantum number will be 2J plus 1 times degenerate. According to the quantum mechanics, this spin angular momentum quantum number will be 2J plus 1 times degenerate, and the values of J, that is MJ, will be will vary from plus J to minus J. Okay, so from this we can see the, if it is 2J plus 1 time degenerate, then there is every possibility that we can get this number of components in case of these systems where we have spin orbit coupling. Okay, now that is why, because of this spin orbit coupling, the transition metal complexes have complicated spectrum in the EPR, and that can be further complicated by the hyperfine splitting, which occurs when our electron spin system interacts with the nuclear spin of that very metal ion on which the unpaired electron is present. So the hyperfine splitting further complicates this type of situation. And now we will take one example. For example, we have a system cobalt 2 plus. We have complex having cobalt 2 plus system. That means it is a D7 system. In D7 system, the number of unpaired electrons n is equal to 3. So our spin angular momentum quantum number will be 3 by 2. And our orbital angular momentum quantum number is 1. Okay, so since here we consider the spin orbit coupling, then the total spin angular momentum quantum number J will be equal to magnitude of L plus S to L minus S. Okay, so from this the value of J will be L plus S, that means 3 plus 3 by 2 plus 1, that will come out 5 by 2 and to 1 by 2. Okay, so we can write 5 by 2, then 3 by 2 and 1 by 2. So three type of total angular momentum quantum numbers, total spin angular momentum quantum number will be represented by these three quantum numbers. Okay, so in case of this system, how we will represent the spectrum? It will be given like this. Firstly, we have a cobalt 2 plus ion. At this very time, all the these values, that is J is equal to five by 2, 3 by 2 and 1 by 2, they are degenerate. Then when the crystal field effects come into existence, that means when the for example it is an octahedral complex, and octahedral this crystal field effects come into play, then at that very time what will happen? Firstly, these d orbitals of the complex, they will lift in degeneracy and give rise to various energy levels due to octahedral crystal field effects. Like we saw in our previous lecture, when the degeneracy of d orbitals gets lifted because of crystal field effects into two sets of degenerate orbitals. But here, in this case, we will get three energy levels, and these are represented by T14, T24, and A24. These are the term symbols for these energy levels. And then, if we consider this ground state, and when the zero field splitting will come into place, or we can say the spin orbit coupling will come into place, what will happen? It will give us 3 energy levels, or we can say the total spin angular momentum quantum will split into 3 states, and they will be represented by J is equal to 5 by 2, J is equal to 3 by 2, and J is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, so it is when there is spin orbit coupling, or zero field splitting. Okay, now further, if we apply the external field, what will happen? When we apply the external field, these all spin states will now these all spin states now will further separate into singly degenerate systems, and they will give us, for example, this 5 by 2, it will give plus 5 by 2, plus 3 by 2, plus 1 by 2, and minus 1 by 2, minus 3 by 2, and minus 5 by 2. Similarly, this system having j equal to 3 by 2, it will give us plus 3 by 2, plus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, and then minus 3 by 2. Okay. Similarly, j is equal to 1 by 2, it will again get split into singly degenerate, that is j is equal to plus 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. These are actually mj values. So the j, which were actually these were sets of degenerate spin states, they got further split into singly degenerate spin states when field was applied. Okay, so from here you can see the firstly the system was actually in this system, firstly the crystal effects came into play, which actually lifted the degeneracy of these d orbitals, and then to lift the degeneracy of the spin status of the electrons, the spin orbit coupling or zero field splitting came into play, and then to further split these degenerated spin status, when the field was applied, they further splitted into singly degenerate. So as a result, the whole spectrum was got a bit complicated. Further, now one more thing can come into play here, that is the hyperfine splitting. If our this metal ion has a nuclear spin, that will interact with each of these mj values, or we can say these spin, singly degenerate spin states, and it can further complicate the spin the EPR spectrum by the phenomenon of hyperfine splitting. Okay, so it is here, and now we can take one more example. For example, now we have another system, V vanadium 3 plus. Okay, so in vanadium 3 plus system, it is actually a D2 system. That means N is equal to 2 and S is equal to 1. Here the orbital angular momentum L is also equal to 1. So the total spin angular momentum quantum number J will be equal to L plus S to L minus S, that is 2, 1 and 0. So the values of J will be 2, 1 and 0. Now we will see it is a EPR spectrum 2, 1, 0, is it is or it is J values. For example, firstly vanadium 3 plus, that is a D2 system. Firstly, the crystal field effects will come into play. Here it is degenerate d orbitals. Now the crystal field effect will come into play, and similar to the previous condition, it will split these and T1, 3, T2, 3 and A2, 3, states of these d orbitals will exist. This is due to octahedral crystal field. And now spin orbit coupling will come into play, or we can say zero field splitting. And at this, the ground state will further split, and we will get three different states corresponding to J is equal to 2, J is equal to 1, and J is equal to 0. okay. Here it is when spin orbit coupling is there. Or zero field splitting. So by spin orbit coupling and zero field splitting, this particular energy level got further splitted as per the different spin angular momentum quantum numbers. Okay, so here the degeneracy was lifted of this very level as per the spin status. And now if we apply the external magnetic field, each of these spin states will further split into singly degenerate spin states. For example, this will give +2, +1, then 0, -1, and -2. Okay, similarly when J is equal to 1, at this time it will give us +1, 0, and -1. Okay, similarly when J is equal to 0, it will again give us MJ is equal to 0, because it is, when J is 0, that means it is already singly degenerate. But there were 3 values possible for this and 5 values of MJ possible for J is equal to 2. These are MJ values. So from here you can see, if the spin orbit coupling is Lorentz, then the energy difference between these levels will be Lorentz. And in that very case, what will happen? The transition from 0 to minus 1, which is actually allowed according to a selection rule, because we have delta ms is equal to +-1. So this 0 to minus 1 transition is allowed. But if the spin orbit coupling or the zero field splitting is Lorentz, what will happen? This transition will not fall in the microwave region. So it will fall in some region which has more energy than in the region of a microwave. So it cannot be observed in case of the EPR spectrum. In contrast to that, we can get these type of transitions, which are also governed by delta ms is equal to +-1. And also we can get those transitions where delta ms is +-2 also. Those we can also get, but if the spin orbit coupling is very large, then this very transition from 0 to -1 will be difficult, because the energy difference between the two will be very high. So it will not fall in the micro region, it will fall in the region having higher energy than the microwave region. Okay, so here we can such kind of situations we can actually experience when we go through the EPR spectra of various complexes under different situations. So before going for the EPR spectrum of a transition metal complex system, what we have to see, we have to take into consideration the crystal field effects, the spin orbit coupling, and the resultant zero field splitting. And also we have to see what is the magnitude of this zero field splitting, and why the particular type of allowed transition is not being observed in case of this EPR spectrum. Those things we have to take care of. Okay, so these are a few examples which actually might have given you the idea that what type of precautions or what type of concepts we have to take care of during actually determining the EPR spectrum of a transition metal complex system. Okay, now if we have an organic molecule in a triplet state, for example, we have naphthalene in triplet state, that means we have the unpaired electrons over here. Now we can actually generate this naphthalene interpolator by using some ultraviolet source. So firstly, if it was in ground state, that means both electrons will be in the same orbital, and when it is in ground state situation, now if we have triplet status, what are the possibilities of spin status in case of the triplet state? We can see, firstly, for example, these both the electrons can have upward spin. Okay, the another possibility is that one has upward spin and one has downward spin, and the another possibility is that both have downward spin. Okay, so on this basis we can have ms is equal to 1, ms is equal to 0, and ms is equal to minus 1. So there are three spin states possible in case of the triplet state of the of naphthalene. Okay, so these three spin states are equally probable. So they will be degenerate when we are not taking the spin orbit coupling, or we are not taking into consideration the zero field splitting or the crystal field effects. Then how we can actually differentiate the spectra of these systems on the basis of the magnitude of zero field splitting? Okay, for example, if we have a when there is no zero field splitting, then ms is equal to 0 plus 1, 0 and minus 1. The three spin states will be equally probable, they will be degenerate, and when there is no zero field splitting, all the three spin states will be degenerate. At this very time, if we apply the magnetic field, external magnetic field, what will happen? These spin states will give us a singly degenerate spin states, and this will be plus 1, ms is equal to plus 1 and 0 and then minus 1. Okay, so in this case we get two transitions in the EPR spectrum, and two lines will be observed in this case. But it is when there was no zero field splitting. Now if there is some zero field splitting, for example, if we have a system where firstly it was ms is equal to plus 1, 0 and minus 1, and now the zero field splitting comes into play, what will happen? These levels will get what will happen? Firstly, there will be two energy levels, ms is equal to plus minus 1, because it will form a Cramer's doublet, and there will be one more spin state, that is 0, it will be lower in energy. So here, this is when there was zero field splitting, and now when we apply the applied magnetic field, so external magnetic field, what will happen? It will give us plus 1, it is 0, and then we will get minus 1. Ms is equal to plus 1, 0 and minus 1. So the transition possible will be from here to here and here to here. Again, we will get two types of transitions over here. So firstly, there was no zero field splitting, and all the three spin states were degenerate. When the spins, zero field splitting came into existence, then according to the Cramer's rule, we get two sets of energy spin states. One is 0 and another is plus minus 1. That means it is a doublet, Cramer's doublet. And then if we apply the field, external field, what happened? This Cramer's doublet also got resolved into two singly degenerate spin states. Okay, so here is some moderate quantity of the zero field splitting was here, and now if we have very less zero field splitting, At that very time, what will happen? These two energy levels will be very close to each other. Okay, so at that very time, what we will get? These two spin states will be very close to each other, and that very time when there is very small zero field splitting. Okay, so at this very time, what we will get? We get ms plus 1, and then we have 0, then ms minus 1. We will get like this. In this case, ms delta ms is equal to plus minus 1 type of transitions are possible, that is minus 1 to 0 and 0 to plus 1. And also there can be possibility of a transition, that is minus 1 to plus 1, that is delta ms is equal to plus minus 2. It is also possible because these energy levels will be very close to each other in that case when there is very small zero field splitting. So in when the zero field magnitude of zero field splitting is very small, at that very time some other extra transitions or lines can be observed in case of Hipper spectrum which are governed by delta ms is equal to plus minus 2 or plus minus 3, etc. Okay, and now if we have a system which has very large this zero field splitting, at that very time there's two spin states will be very far from each other, and this is for example ms is equal to 0 and ms plus minus 1. In this very situation, what will happen? It is very large zero field splitting. Okay, when there is very large zero field splitting, what will happen? When we apply the external magnetic field, this will be as ms plus 1 and ms minus 1, and this ms 0, this will be ms 0. At this very time, the transitions between this and 0 to minus 1 or minus 1 to plus 1, they will be difficult. And so in this situation, when there is very large zero field splitting, what will happen? We will not observe the EPR spectrum in this kind of situation. Okay, so on this basis we can say that the magnitude of zero field splitting, or the in case of these organic molecules, that can actually give us the idea what kind of spectrum we can get. Similarly, in case of transition metal complexes, the zero field splitting or the spin orbit coupling, their what is their magnitude, on that basis the complexity of the EPR spectrum can be ascertained. Okay, thank you very much for today.